I recognize this guy. This is, of course, Olaf from the Disney film Frozen. A snowstorm finally dumped enough snow in Wisconsin.
I thought it was Jack Pluto.
Well, that's his twin. Yeah, that's Olaf Pluto.
It looked like a smile there.
Yeah. But that was actually in Wisconsin. They got a lot of snow up there and able to finally build some snowmen up that way. Us, not so much here in the Tri-States.
No snowmen being built right now. We have no snow. Yeah. But, you know,
I'm not complaining.
Temperatures are going to be cold enough to do just that. Look at that, 32 degrees currently up in Macomb on our live view up into the heart of Macomb. On the town square there, clouds moved in, and temperatures are going to be falling off area-wide as a big batch of cold air slides down from the northlands of Canada and the United States, the northern part of the country, all the way down through our backyards here in the Tri-States over the next 48 hours. So right now, we don't have any real precip. A few scattered snow shower returns earlier today up over southern parts of Iowa. We could see a few scattered patches of flurries tonight as this cold air sinks southward across the area. Outside of the clouds and some scattered flurries, the big news will be the temperatures. They're in the 30s right now, lower 30s, mid-30s, depending on where you live, 36 in Hannibal, 30 up in Fort Madison. But the coldest of air is to our north, and it's going to be pushing southward as we go on through tonight and tomorrow. So we'll look for some flurries around possibly. Outside of that, those will probably, once again, the clouds and the flurries come to an end sometime first thing tomorrow morning. We'll get some sun in here tomorrow afternoon, which will be nice, but it's not going to warm us up. Temperatures are going to be locked in the 20s for highs tomorrow on into Wednesday. As a matter of fact, Wednesday morning, we should see low temperatures somewhere around 5 or 6, 7 degrees, something like that, above zero. And the wind chill values, they'll be about 5 to 10 degrees below zero. That's what it will actually feel like outside. So get ready for this cold blast. It is going to mean some business for us. Now, as far as any precipitation goes, good chances of any wintry stuff. Maybe on Saturday, a mix of rain and snow should push through the region. It's a little early yet to say, but that's our next big chance anyway. 32 degrees right now at the airport with clouds. And we have a north breeze at 7 miles per hour. Winds generally across the tri-states here at 5 o'clock are out of the north-northeast. And that's the direction they're going to be pulling that colder air down across much of Iowa, Illinois, and Missouri as we go through the next day or so. 32 degrees currently here in Quincy. You've got 26 up in Chicago, 20 in Des Moines. Cold stuff out to the northwest there in Omaha where they're in the teens. So we've got this north-northeast flow that will be coming down across the area. High pressure out over the central plains will build eastward as we head on into tomorrow night. We'll get the winds out of the northwest tomorrow, but some sun later on tomorrow afternoon by midday on through the afternoon hours. So that'll be nice to look at, but it's not going to be very warm at all tomorrow. Lows tonight in the teens to lower 20s, and then tomorrow we'll take temperatures on up into the lower to middle 20s for daytime highs, below average temperatures all across the tri-states. 18 for a low tonight. The clouds will be out there, maybe a few patchy areas of flurries. Tomorrow, flurries and clouds start to break up first thing in the morning. We'll look for some sun in the afternoon with cold highs in the lower 20s. Your 7-day forecast will show the following. Lower 20s again on Wednesday for the first day of 2015 on Thursday. Look at that, 32 degrees, dry weather and partly sunny skies. As a matter of fact, we'll see temperatures try and ramp up into the mid-30s on Friday. There's that chance of a little coverage of some rain and snow showers on Saturday. Originally, Ross, that system looked like it might be a little more powerful, bringing us some snow Friday night and Saturday. Latest indications are more of a mix of rain and snow shower chances, and then more 30s for Sunday.
And just like that, New Year's Day creeping up, and off into January we go.
That's right. New Year's Eve night, not looking bad. New Year's Day looking dry, so temperature is pretty comfortable, too, at least for this time of year.
Sure. All right. Thanks, Mike. Well, it is a hugely popular